That there's something wrong with this expressway. They may not be able to put their finger right on it, but they know that it's damaging. That's a classic example, but in 16 other U.S. cities at the present moment, major highway programs are delayed, held up. In many other cities, they've been abandoned completely.
Let it stop here, for Ab Campbell says it's got to go further down. $77 million has been spent since that's been done. We thought just for fun.
And, you know, I can also see the connection between the Spadina Expressway and the Manhattan.
Spadina, Spadina, the new Northwest Passage coming through. Even though expressways are outmoded, obsolete, and always loaded, traffic experts know what to do. 16 years ago, Cedar Vale said no. Now it's a fact they can't deny. Since it's on their doorstep, they say...
We must have oil to supply our automobiles, and in order to accommodate the automobiles, we must... build roads and destroy housing.
Those cars in our community, pollution, noise, and traffic would be ours. Get on a roll and make sure that it keeps going.
Choices have never been put to the people. Roads do not solve traffic problems, they create traffic problems.
Road. It picks up briefly at that point and then slows down once again as you get right up north of Eglinton Avenue. So all in all, it's pretty much a disaster scene. And if you're heading northbound, forget the parkway. If you're heading out of the city, forget about the Gardner also. From York Street right through to Dufferin, traffic is pretty well bumper to bumper. Lakeshore looks pretty good if you'd like to use that as an alternate route. And now somewhere
the Metro Chairman street, now admits that he doesn't use the Don Valley Expressway anymore because it's too congested.
Right down to both Northman and northbound and Islington, almost right down to
things that most people hold dear in the city are the sort of small human places. It's a reversal of the planning process we've been using for the last 50 years. Essentially a daytime occupancy. Don't worry, kids. The expressway brings a whole pile of wide open space. The first five floors of the five apartment buildings built on the George Washington Expressway in New York City have had to be evacuated because the pollution count is at 150 parts per million.
We had to change the situation at an exit maybe 203. A big ramp at Davenport so that we don't cut it short. This will surely ease the concentration. Spadina, Spadina, the new Northwest Passage coming through. Expressways are outmoded, obsolete, and all the other traffic experts know what to do.
You would think that any responsible politician would stop now and ask for the whole thing to be reviewed. So they're not trying to design the best system. They're just trying to design a system. Every case, the transit-oriented system met those criteria better than any other system. But it would also cost us $1 billion less.
All those cars have no place to go. They're all triple parked and their tires are getting marked. Police tickets brighten the decor. But there's no room for...
The provincial government is the place to look at.
Maybe it should not stop there. Push it further south, right through the harbor mouth, and park the cars in Lake Ontario.
And it is a 75% subsidy, and somebody in Sudbury is paying for a road that nobody wants in Toronto. Politicians trying to be planners, and planners trying to be politicians. Corporate institutional set of objectives which are in direct conflict with human objectives. Confrontation going on now, and any student of confrontation politics can come and study this fight. And in the middle is a big, beautiful green field for a hero to emerge on. Somewhere in Canada, this man exists, and we're going to keep that field green and in the sunshine waiting for that man to arrive. Proceed in the education process, the education of politicians, and devote our time to this, that ultimately they will understand what we're talking about.